time now is 8 minutes past 8.
Let's return to our main story and news that North Korea is ending the testing of intercontinental nuclear weapons and will shut down a nuclear testing centre.
Let's talk now to our Seoul correspondent, Laura Bicker. Very good morning to you, Laura. So, on the face of it, this looks like a very significant announcement. Just talk us through what are the realities and the practicalities.
Okay, so Kim Jong-un has announced through the state-run media agency that he's willing to stop nuclear testing, intercontinental ballistic missile testing, that he's going to close down one of his atomic test sites. That, as you say, on the face of it, looks significant. The problem is what he didn't say. He didn't say he's prepared to give up his weapons, denuclearize, hand any of these nuclear weapons over. And when it comes to that atomic site itself, well, there are reports that it was badly damaged back in September in that last nuclear test that they made. So it may well be that that site couldn't have been used anyway. So there are those caveats. However, I've just been speaking to one expert here who's been listening to North Korea for a long time, and he says it's time to really listen to North Korea and what North Korea wants. He believes that this is Kim Jong-un trying to reach out to the wider world, try to normalise his country and be part of Asia, be part of this region. And that is one way to read his remarks, because this really lays the groundwork for a summit with the South Korean leader next Friday, Moon Jae-in, and also a potential meeting between Kim Jong-un and the US president. It does seem as if Kim Jong-un wants this meeting to happen. And if he does, this is a good way of saying to Donald Trump, look, this is what I'm prepared to do. This is his starting point. So it's not his end point. And it may well be in the summits he's prepared to go further. But again, when it comes to North Korea, it's like reading tea leaves, because we're not sitting next to Kim Jong-un. We've got to rely on what we're told through the state-run media agencies.
Laura, thank you very much for that reporting from Seoul for us this morning.
Let's talk now to John Hemmings, who's Director of Asia Studies at the Henry Jackson Society. Joins us now from our London newsroom. Good morning to you. Thanks for your time this morning. So what do you make of what Kim Jong-un has offered in terms of changes to the nuclear programme?
Well, the analysis that was just given was very good. I think cautious but optimistic. You do have someone who is frozen tests and you know, is taking down a weapons testing site. But remember, in 2012, the Obama administration came to the same point before it all fell down, when North Korea decided to test a ballistic missile, but it said it was having a satellite launch. And because the technology was the same, the Obama administration, the whole agreement collapsed at the time. And so I wonder if they've learned from that, and that they know this time not to do that again. If I remember correctly, They were in New York with American diplomats, and they kind of said it as they were going out the door after signing the leap year agreement, by the way, we'll be testing, you know, be launching a satellite in 3 months. And the Americans were kind of gobsmacked. So I'm very much hoping that this segment, this leg of negotiations, we're going to see an avoidance of that.
Well, President Trump has tweeted that this is good news for the world. So he appears, at least on the surface, to be taking this positively.
Yeah, I think he's, you know, also signaling to his domestic constituency, signaling to both the North Koreans and the Chinese that he will take that as evidence of good faith and that the negotiations continue. You know, I suppose we're all a bit surprised how quickly we've come to this point. It's very difficult because it's been very, almost volatile, but very fluid and very fast compared to usual. It has a bit of a resemblance to the events before 1989, where one bit of good news follows another. But we shouldn't read, I hate to say it, but we shouldn't read too much into it yet. Cautious and optimism.
And also in terms of what this means for North Korea and South Korea's relationship, what do you make of that?
Well, I think it's great news for them. Of course, it comes right into the lead up to their talks and their efforts to sign a peace agreement and to end the armistice. I mean, I think that is hugely symbolic. I've always been personally critical of it because the North Koreans tended to want to do it just with the Americans and kind of sideline the South Koreans. But the fact that they're going directly to Seoul, to me, has spoken that they see South Korea as an equal agent, one worthy of respect and negotiation. So I'm highly optimistic. I'm very positive about Moon Jae-in, President Moon Jae-in's diplomacy. You know, he's very progressive, and yet he's managed to handle someone as conservative as Donald Trump. He's managed to handle the Chinese fairly well, and he's done all this very, very well without dropping into the kind of morass that his mentor, Romu Hyun, did when he kind of fell out with everyone trying to push through the sunshine policy. So my hat's off to him.
Okay, positive. John Hemmings, thank you very much for joining us from Asia Studies Centre at the Henry Jackson Society. Thank you.
8:14 the time now. So we've had a couple of days of...